Supported by Invergrove Hyundai. This is AM 980 The Mission, KKMS Richfield, the Twin Cities Christian voice.
With SRN News, I'm Keith Peters in Washington. President Trump is getting briefed on Midwestern flood damage as he visits Nebraska prior to participating in political events in Iowa. March flooding caused at least $3 billion in damage in Nebraska, Iowa, Missouri, and Kansas. About two dozen levee systems were breached or overtopped during the Missouri River flooding that devastated parts of the state. A centerpiece of the U.S.-Mexico deal on immigration calls for rapid expansion of a new policy that makes Central American asylum seekers wait in Mexico while their cases wind through U.S. immigration courts. It's too early to say if the policy will achieve its goal of deterring more migrants from coming. On Wall Street, the Dow down by 14 points to 26,048. The NASDAQ unchanged. The S&P dropped one. Oil down a penny. It closed at $53.27 a barrel. This is SRN News.
And this is AM 980 The Mission. We are the Twin Cities Christian Voice. Happy Tuesday. Thank you for joining us. 401 in the Kingdom Builders Roofing Studio. We have Lee Michaels Live coming up next, a special edition of Lee Michaels Live. Lee is on assignment, and in his place, we have Pastor Dwight Anderson and Jim Moore of Prison Transformation Radio, heard Saturdays at 1 p.m. right here on AM 980 The Mission. If you ever miss out on the show, Prison Transformation Radio, you can always catch up at the podcast page at am980themission.com. They are all there, the whole library of programs. Lee Michaels Live coming up next, but a quick look at weather first. Overcast out there, about 60, and it looks like we'll see showers through the evening hours and into Wednesday morning. Sometime on Wednesday, it starts to clear up. We could see some sunshine later on Wednesday. Mild temps, though, mid to upper 60s. We got Lee Michaels Live coming up next here from the Kingdom Builders Roofing Studio. Stay with us. We are The Mission, and we are the Twin Cities Christian Voice.
Hey, your home has some real nice gutters, said no one ever. It's Matthew with the Kingdom Builders. No one notices gutters until there's a problem. Whether you've had damage from an ice dam from the long, hard winter, water in your basement, or you've just been thinking about the health of your gutters for a while, call the Kingdom Builders. We fabricate 5- and 6-inch seamless gutters right on site, and they're specifically designed and color matched to your home. We also mount stainless steel micro mesh gutter covers to keep your system clean. No getting up on a ladder and wondering what you'll find. A budding tree, an irritated robin, or the neighbor kid's lacrosse ball. We're talking minimum maintenance for years to come. Plus, they look great. So let us take care of the most underappreciated but very important part of your roof, your gutter system. Call the Kingdom Builders today, 612-900-9166, or find us online at thekingdombuilders.net. That's thekingdombuilders.net. We're not salespeople, we're just great gutter installers.
Entertaining.
I've never heard anything quite like it.
Really?
Engaging.
That's pretty cool.
Encouraging.
Surely I say unto you dudes,
I do not wish to fight.
Pursuing the truth and helping you live out a life in Christ.
Hey, want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
It's Lee Michaels Live.
He's a righteous dude.
On AM 980, The Mission.
Well, we got a couple more righteous dudes for you. I don't know. I don't know if that's disrespectful. Pastor Dwight Anderson, Prison Mission Association,
good to be here.
A righteous dude, and also one of the hosts of Prison Transformation Radio.
Yes.
And my name is Jim Moore. I'm just Jim. I'm not a pastor, but I do work a lot in the recovery community, bringing resources to people, and that's what R3 is. But we're just excited about being here, and we got a room full here. So we've got guests from Prison Transformation Radio. We're talking about outreach. What are you looking forward to, Pastor?
Yeah, let's do outreach.
Let's do outreach. Yeah. That's our theme of the month.
Yes, that's our theme of the month. I got a verse just to open there, too. Romans 1:16 says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God that brings salvation to everyone who believes, first to the Jews and then to the Gentiles." And so it's the power of God unto salvation. So it's exciting. And maybe people listening today really don't understand the gospel, and they need to hear the good news too. So it's great for us to be able to share.
And don't take that personal out there. We don't mean to. But we want a challenge, right?
We want a challenge
to dig it at
absolutely.
A deeper level.
Absolutely.
And Pastor Dwight Anderson, we just want to not boast, but we've been working hard, folks, on Prison Transformation Radio, and both of us for a decade or two. out in the field. So just to introduce ourselves a little bit, I'm a former pathetic drug addict. And
that was 10 years ago.
That was 10 years ago. Yeah, former.
Yeah. You're former.
Oh, it's been great.
Yeah.
But it was 10 years ago. A couple of good things happened. I met Jesus Christ at Minnesota Adult and Teen Challenge. Mm-hmm. That's Amen. The best thing that happened. I went there for a short-term treatment, stayed there for a year. But you know what also happened? I met Lee Michaels.
That's right.
I was one of the students from Minnesota Adult and Teen Challenge who they brought down to the studio here in Eagan to tell their story and their testimony. So I don't mean to be too down and out about the pathetic drug addict thing, but it's a tough life. It's a prison of addiction.
That's right.
And your expertise, Pastor, mm-hmm. is more in the concrete prisons. Yes. Tell us a little bit about what Prison Mission Association is.
Yeah, Prison Mission Association. We started back in 1955. A guy named Joe Mason was going and visiting the jails and the prisons there. And a lot of times these guys and the women would be moved to other prisons and jails, and he wouldn't be able to connect with them. So he developed the correspondence course, getting them into God's Word, being able to mentor them. And so we've developed that course, and they can actually earn college credit for doing our courses.
Well, I love what you do.
And we have... And since I became director 4 years ago, we've added over 14,000 new students. Now we have 33,000 students in all 50 states. So if anybody's listening wants to study the Bible, you don't have to be in prison to do our lessons. And you don't have to be in prison to get the college credit either. So they can connect with me or go to prisonmission.org is our website.
Perfect.
And just ask for those lessons and we'll mail those out to you.
Perfect. And wonderful work that you do. And you're everywhere, all over the place. Just Wheaton College recently, you were talking about. And so thank you for being
there.
A voice for prison transformation, not just on the radio,
right,
but in every day. And and one thing we want to do, folks, is, we want to lighten up, have fun, because we were talking about that with our guests, and we actually have a few people in the studio. Some have been on Prison Transformation Radio before.
Mm-hmm.
Some are going to be, Pastor Dwight, on the next couple Saturdays at 1 p.m.
Right.
on AM 980. They're going to be our guests on Prison Mission Association, well, I guess, or Prison Transformation Radio. They humor me, folks, because I flub. But we just get up, Pastor.
It's okay.
We just get up.
That's
so,
all right.
So our guests are. But a little bit about the work. What I think this was on my heart driving down to the studio today is I want you to know, folks, that there are thousands of resources, treatment programs, mm-hmm. counseling programs available. I have been so overwhelmed in my last year or two working with the R3 Collaborative, how many resources exist.
Wow.
It's tough to navigate. Mm-hmm. You know, so that's what a lot of our mission is, people coming out of prison. Let's get them the housing, the mentors, jobs, educational programs.
Right.
But not just those coming out of prison, those coming out of treatment,
Absolutely.
Too. Because if they don't create a life that is more rewarding mm-hmm. in Christ and professionally and financially, there's a tendency to slip back to
that's
the
exactly
life,
right.
the previous life.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of what we're up to, folks, is we're up to helping the most lost.
Mm-hmm.
And our guests are going to be talking about that, right?
Yep.
And what do you think about this Let's Do Outreach thing that we got going?
I love it. I love it.
People
it's the
greatest. You're an outreach kind of guy?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. I'm the director of outreach at Bethesda Church.
Come on.
Hey, I do outreach. I do outreach in the prisons. We go all kinds. I was just in Faribault Prison last Wednesday all day.
See?
Giving the gospel out. Yeah. So,
and that's the most exciting thing to me. I think we can offer you something, folks. Driving home or listening on your computer. Or I talked to my boys today. They don't have an AM radio, but they're online. They're streaming live on AM980Division.com.
Awesome.
So you can do that too. But we want to invite you folks to join the conversation. So we're going to be here for 2 hours. Our guests are going to be conversating with us. There is a call in number, and you can talk to the man behind the scenes for our show. But he is the co-host, if I can say that, John, with Lee Michaels. John Berg, he's a producer, he's mm-hmm. a predict. He does everything.
I do it all, that's right.
And if they call in, they can talk to John personally.
I get friends calling in just to catch up with me.
See, there you go.
Lee sees me in here on the phone, and he's going, oh, I wonder if I got a call. And no, they're just calling to talk to me, Lee.
So we'll keep repeating this number as we go.
Absolutely.
But the call-in number in the studio to John is 651-289-4499. And you can join the conversation.
Absolutely.
And what we want to do is we want to give you an opportunity to join the larger conversation. There's easy ways to get involved. Volunteers, mentoring. We can give you safe, easy ways to join the local mission field.
Mm-hmm.
Inner city, Minneapolis, and St. Paul. Don't be scared. Right. We don't have a spirit of fear. That's not what he gave us.
But if you
get training and you're equipped and you can join a band of people who have been working in the inner city for years, there's a safe way where you can join us.
Yeah.
And it's the adventure of a lifetime.
Should we give a little teaser about what's coming up so people
Teaser, that's
something?
Radio talk. Tease them, Pastor. Tease them. Yeah. What's coming up?
Yeah. Well, after the break, we've got a guy who a lot of people say he looks like Santa Claus.
Because he does.
So, and he's been on our show before, so I don't know if you should keep him as a mystery gift, a mystery guest. I've flubbed up.
Yeah, well, I'm wearing off on you. But it is Chaplain Dave Johnson.
Yes.
We'll go ahead and plug these
there
things.
There he is.
Lost Sheep Ministry, Rescuing the Brokenhearted.
Mm-hmm.
And we're talking a man who is in the inner city, in Teen Challenge, in the Salvation Army. Anybody who needs help with Christ, with treatment, with recovery, 24/7, Dave is on the march.
Yeah,
and
he's
so awesome. We're looking forward to having Dave back again in a few minutes.
Right.
Yeah. Yep. So who else is coming up, Pastor?
Okay. After that, we've got Pastor Julie Jacobs of Frontier of Church Fellowship and Let's Do Outreach in St. Paul.
Yep. Frontier of Church or Fellowship. Or
it says Frontier,
Frontier Fellowship.
Church. Okay.
I know. I probably flubbed it up.
Okay.
Frontier Fellowship.
Okay. Sorry about that. And then we've got Pastor Angel Montanez of King of Glory. Let's Do Outreach in South Minneapolis.
And he's been on the streets for years.
Yeah.
No, this pastor has a church right on, I don't know if you know South Minneapolis, folks, but Bloomington and Lake Street. That's in the heart of the South Minneapolis inner city. And Pastor Angel broke loose. I'm working on my Spanish, but that's how you say angel in
that's
Spanish.
That's how you say
Angel.
Angel.
You don't have to say broke loose,
but
he helps me remember
this.
But Pastor Angel, and he's going to be sharing you not only what they've been doing for years, but with the support of Pastor Julie from Frontier Fellowship, we're making a concerted, coordinated effort in St. Paul and in South Minneapolis. And I got some ideas for North Minneapolis.
Okay.
Where we can, like we said, in a safe way, bring people into these mm-hmm. these places to join us and join Chaplain Dave. Right out there, man, giving sandwiches, giving gloves, giving Jesus. There's work to be done on the streets in Minneapolis. Yeah.
Yeah, so if you're listening, you want to tune in or call in, sorry, the number is 651-289-4499. And so we'd love your feedback or any discussion or ideas you might have for outreach in the Twin Cities, because we're trying to encourage the suburban churches to get involved in coming to the inner city.
There may be a mystery guest coming. And he is actually our guest on the next two Saturdays, Jason Houle, who is the director of Native Strong ARC,
mm-hmm.
Authentic Relationship with the Creator. And Native Strong brings the gospel through 21st century technology to the reservations.
That's awesome.
Podcasts, videos, internet. Mm-hmm. And I think Jason's on the road. So Jason, if you're listening, say hey.
Hey.
but he may join us in the second hour. If not, Pastor, we can talk about his shows coming up the next couple Saturdays.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. That sounds good.
Yeah. So folks, call in, man.
We're
getting kind of lonely in here. No, we do. We just, Lee, wherever you are on vacation or holiday, thank you for opening up the time, because this is really a gift for us to be on the afternoon show and to share this with you.
Hmm.
So any other updates in our first segment here on Prison Mission Association? Or let's start with you.
Yeah.
How can they get involved with you? Because they can actually participate in prison ministry
in
the safety of their own home.
Absolutely.
Talk about that.
Yes, yes. Yeah, you can correct lessons. I need volunteers, because all of these students, they mail the lessons in, and then we need people to correct those lessons, mentor them, answer questions, and pray for them. So they can contact me. My cell phone number is 612-423-3457, and I can talk to you over the phone, or you can email me or connect me with the website. And so if you can just Google Prison Mission Association.
Googling's a good
Googling
trick.
It. Yeah. And then you can get my phone number on the website. We also have YouTube videos with testimonials and things like that. And we have a Facebook and Twitter.
There's Johnny.
And there's the music.
Here's Johnny.
So you've been listening to Lee Michaels Live with Prison Mission Associates, sorry, Prison Transformation Radio Edition.
Yes, sir.
We're just about to go to the break and catch up with the news, but come back to us, and we're going to have Dave Johnson with Lost Sheep Ministries.
Amen.
Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Padilla. I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man.
This Saturday, it's our exclusive event, Dive In, Dinner and Discussion with Dr. Sebastian Gorka, supported by Minnesota's Closet and Storage Concepts. Find tickets for this one-of-a-kind event at am980themission.com.
The following is not an actor, but a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
I had a lot of credit card debt, and I couldn't pay my bills. I was feeling so bad. I got to a point where I needed some help. So I reached out and contacted Trinity.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-936-5496 to talk to a certified counselor.
They were able to take all of my different payments and put them all together.
Trinity will consolidate your accounts into one easy-to-manage monthly payment, put a stop to late fees and over-limit charges, reduce your interest, and possibly improve your credit score. You'll save thousands.
And they were actually able to work with my creditors. I've been able to pay off close to $15,000 in the last 18 months.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-936-5496.
My name is Stephanie, and I'm debt-free for keeps.
1-800-936-5496.
Midwest Fence is the type of fence company your brother, your uncle, your cousin, or your neighbor would recommend, because they too went with them for their fence and figured out pretty quickly Midwest was the obvious choice. Not only were the costs kept low because Midwest Fence is the largest fence company in the state and thus buys in bulk and passes the savings on to you, but just the fact that this company has vastly more experience with fences than anyone else gives a person a certain peace of mind. Folks, they've been at this since Truman was president. Driving down the road in Minnesota, you see the handiwork of Midwest Fence all around you. And those people who went with Midwest will tell you it was hardly a difficult decision. You won't find a greater variety of design options, nor more down-to-earth people ready to work with you. Midwest Fence, the ones your neighbors recommend. Learn more at MidwestFence.com.
This is Stacy on her motorcycle.
What an incredible view!
And this is Stacy off her motorcycle.
Does this have sucralose in it?
On her motorcycle.
Oh, the wind in my hair!
Off her motorcycle.
It's pronounced etc., not etc.
On.
Woohoo! Yes!
Off.
No.
You're better on your bike. And with basic policy starting at $75 a year, quote today at progressive.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates. Annual premium for basic liability policy not available in all states.
Here's part of a real post from a real Chick-fil-A fan. Josh writes,
"You had me at candied bacon."
Thanks, Josh. It wouldn't be the Smokehouse Barbecue Bacon Sandwich without the sugared and peppered bacon. Try one for yourself at your nearest Chick-fil-A. Real Chick-fil-A customers paid for their testimonial.
As the rain begins to move out of the metro area, what's left behind are still some wet roads, so a little extra caution advised. As westbound 94 is still tight, Riverside to the Lowry Hill Tunnel, then Dowling to 694, where there's a crash off to the right shoulder at 53rd. Highway 169 to Brockton Lane also on the brakes. Eastbound 94 off of 394 to 35W slow, then Riverside to Snelling with a crash on the right shoulder. And again, stop at Gilmarion Street to 35E. 394 eastbound is heavy. Highway 100 to 94. 35W northbound county from Highway 36 to County Road 96. And southbound Highway 10 to 694 sluggish. That's traffic. I'm Bill Lindy.
Welcome back, everybody. This is Jim Moore with the R3 Collaborative and Prison Transformation Radio. And my honorable co-host Pastor Dwight Anderson with Prison Mission Association.
Yeah,
welcome back, Pastor.
Yeah, that was
like we went somewhere.
Yeah, we didn't go.
So let's jump into it again. Yes. Remember the call-in number, folks, and we're just going to keep reminding and prompting and motivating. But it's 651-289-4499. And we were talking while you guys were listening to the break about we got help, we got support, If you've got a story of a life transformed in Christ out of prison or out of addiction, tell a story, man. Let's spread some hope around this place.
Yes.
Maybe, on the other hand, you're brokenhearted. Maybe you're struggling. Listen to Chaplain Dave, because this guy is dedicated, and he'll reach out to you personally, or you can call in. And we can talk about it.
Absolutely.
About Teen Challenge, access to treatment. Maybe you're a mom or a dad.
Right.
You know, let's get the word out there on how people can get easy access. And that seems to be what you're all about, Chaplain Dave.
Yes.
I love you, my brother. I love who you are. I love a brother in Christ. You're one of my heroes, though. On the front line, it's Lost Sheep Ministries, and that is rescuing the brokenhearted. So tell the Christian church out there what you're up to, Chaplain Dave. What's your work?
Yeah, well, thank you so much for having me. I guess it's the words of Jesus where, you know, I mean, he left the 99 to go out after that one that was lost. And God put that on my heart through a situation that happened where a 19-year-old kid overdosed and died. And I went to his funeral, and I knew his mom. And when she saw me, she was just sobbing on my shoulder. And God started a conversation with me saying, you need to go out after these sheep of mine that, you know, make, you know, sometimes bad choices, but they don't have to keep going.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so that's really what started the whole thing. And God was, he wasn't going to let me...
He got a hold of you on this one, didn't he?
Yeah, it's just like day and night he kept kind of like hammering this thing. And so I became convinced that that's what he wanted me to do, and it's really been a blessing.
And first of all, I knew Dave at Minnesota Adult and Teen Challenge, where I worked as well for 10 years. Also, I knew of just how many people respected you with your work in the Salvation Army Adult Rehabilitation Center. So through many, many years of that work, you really developed a gift to meet people where they're at without tripping on them, without putting a guilt trip, but just meet them where they're at, not necessarily getting all religious about it. And just keep saying it, folks, meeting them where they're at. So most of what I heard you first doing was responding to calls for help from family members.
Yep.
And then that's kind of grown into this let's do outreach. But let's start with, you know, what those calls for help are like. How did people reach you? Give people a couple of examples because they may want to call.
Yeah, well, this is really interesting because I went down to Minnesota Adult and Teen Challenge in Rochester on Saturday with a team of 10 people.
Oh, just a couple days ago Saturday.
Yes.
You're still going, man.
Yeah, and we prayed for 30 of the ladies that were in a program down there, and it was amazing. And one of the moms, though, spoke to me and said that her daughter was in a really bad situation, and so I gave her my card. And so Saturday, when we got back, I get a call from this woman on the phone, and I couldn't hardly understand her. She was whispering and crying at the same time and under the influence. And so I said, are you, you know, in a safe place? And she said, no. And I said, okay, you know what? I'd like to come and get you. Can you text me your phone number? And so not her phone number, but her address where she was at.
Yeah.
And so she texted me her address, and 15 minutes later, I was there with my sister Kathy and another friend, Mary Ann. We pulled up in her house, and I texted her and said, okay, we're outside your house. Just come out. And she came out, and she went into the garage and talked to a guy that was in the garage, and then she went back in the house, and then we're talking, and it's like, okay, I'm going to give her like 5 more minutes, and then if she doesn't come out, I'm going in there, and I'm going to say, you know what?
Sounds like a TV show or something. Well, we'll talk about that.
Yeah.
Powerful.
I was going to say, this is my granddaughter, you know, let her come out right now, and if you don't let her out, I'm going to call the police, you know, so... Yeah, it was...
How to meet people where they're at.
Yeah, it didn't come to that, you know, so she did come out.
But are a seasoned veteran at it, is what I'm hearing.
Yeah. Anyhow, we took her to our house, and she stayed at our house then Saturday and Sunday, and then I said, on Monday, I'd like to be able to take you to Teen Challenge to get a Rule 25.
Which is an assessment.
Yeah, chemical assessment.
And that's how you get funded.
Yes.
Usually no out-of-pocket expense, folks.
Right.
Insurance, county funding.
Yeah. And she didn't have an appointment, so I said, let's go early because there might be a cancellation or they might try to work you in, you know, and get you that Rule 25. And so we went and they did work her in. And so they said that she was approved. They got funding approved the same day. It was amazing. Wow. They said that she could have come in the program yesterday, but she didn't. She had to take care of some stuff to get her clothes and whatnot. And so this morning, I had to go back to Rochester and speak in chapel. And I brought, you know, some friends of mine from the healing rooms who had gone down with me on Saturday. And it's Stephen and Ann Chan. And they came along, and my sister was there, and Marianne was there. And then, unbeknownst to the mother who was in the program down there, we brought her daughter down there. Uh-huh. And when we came in
into
the door,
into
the program, the mom didn't know that the daughter was going to do that, you know. I mean, they both broke down crying, and all the people, you know, the girls that were in the ladies in the program were just overwhelmed, you know,
and just
with joy.
Welcoming and embracing it's just incredible. The spirit of Christ, the
it was
heart
beautiful.
And love.
It was absolutely beautiful, yeah. And so then I took her back to Minneapolis, and she got into the program at Teen Challenge right at noon today.
Excellent.
Praise
yeah,
praise
so it was pretty amazing.
And that is, I thank you for sharing it that way. So I want people to understand it's an intimate kind of process. Mm. Dave has been on Prison Transformation Radio a couple of times. And as John said earlier, the podcasts are there. And just, you can scroll through the podcast page and pick out his shows. But one thing we talked about is Christian interventions.
Mm-hmm.
Which is just the way we kind of capsulize it. Because it's not the TV show.
No,
it's not a harder core kind of intervention. Yeah. It's not clinical.
No,
we're not clinicians. We're pastoral.
Yeah.
But it's a nurturing and usually helping people access Christian treatment programs.
Yeah.
And very gentle and no pressure. Yeah. Meet them where they're at. Right.
Right. Yeah. Well, this was an intervention. We had actually went and rescued her from the situation.
But not with all the drama.
No kind
of stuff, which sells on TV. But although I think this would be a good show. Oh, yeah. I can see. Yeah. This guy looks like Santa Claus. You guys.
Yeah.
Can you see him going in there, Pastor
that
Dwight?
Would be good
and
show.
Mom's crying and the daughter's
that
there. Oh.
If you just tuned in, you're listening to Lee Michaels Live. This is a special Prison Transformation Radio edition. And we're speaking with Dave. I lost your name.
Johnson.
Lost Sheep Ministries. Yeah. And Dave, if people are listening now and they need some help, or if they want to volunteer and help or get involved, how can they contact you or how can they get more information?
Yeah, well, you can call me. My cell phone number is 612-414-5575. I'm under David M. Johnson on Facebook, and I do look like Santa. So you can reach out to me there or through Messenger. But, yeah, if you're interested in doing any kind of outreach like this, we can get you plugged in, and God wants to use you.
And so your website?
What's the website?
Yeah, my website is just www.lostsheepministriesmn.org.
And here's a Prison Transformation Radio trick. Google. If you just type in Lost Sheep Ministries, Minnesota, it's going to pop up.
So if
you're driving and can't write that down.
Yeah.
And so there's that individual Christian supportive interventions that you do, but you have also opened up a whole new world for me with your service in the tent communities in Minneapolis and Let's Do Outreach. And you introduced me to Pastor Julie, who's our guest in the upcoming segment.
Mm-hmm.
And so in addition to this individual rescuing the brokenhearted, you also take folks from the Teen Challenge Leadership Institute, students who are learning ministry, and you actually go into the inner city.
Yeah, well, it's people who have a heart for the lost are just drawn to this ministry.
Yeah.
And, you know, they want to love on these people. And, you know, the word says, whatever you do to the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you do unto me. And so that's our marching orders, you know. Yeah. And there's a great need out there.
What kind of needs can people help with, or what kind of things can people do to volunteer or churches?
Well, I mean, so the needs come in a number of forms. I am blessed to be able to receive Bibles from international Bible givers. Mm-hmm. And
that's right.
Yeah, and you know, you're out there too, Dwight.
I'm going there on the 27th this month.
So I really appreciate that. And so we use those Bibles to make connections with people, and we do outreach. Pastor Julie, her church is just phenomenal and really focused on outreach.
And she's in the next segment. We're going to go to a break.
Yeah.
In the next segment, Pastor Dwight, Julie will kind of lay out, here's how you do it, here's the opportunities, and then she'll also do a prison transformation show in depth.
Perfect. That sounds good. We'll look forward to that after the break.
Okay.
In Minnesota, you can take 10,000 different routes to adventure. One path leads you to bluff country biking and world-class hiking trails. Head in a different direction and explore modern art and a historic brewery. Navigate by boat to a lakeside restaurant or cruise downriver with friends on a paddleboard. No matter which route you take, from star-studded concerts to camping under the stars, you're destined to find your true north. Only in Minnesota. Visit exploreminnesota.com.
Here's some great news for people who plan to retire one day. The Sheila Franks Financial Hour is on the air. You know Sheila, or you should. She's CEO and founder of Lifestyle Financial and Tax Advisors Company. Her team has won the People's Choice Award as the best tax preparer for Osseo, Maple Grove, Champlin, and Dayton. Her advice may be the best thing you hear all weekend. It's an hour of insight, information, and strategies you can use to build wealth and keep it. Live good, retire well.
Listen to the Sheila Franks Financial Hour, Saturdays at noon.
So, along with everything else you have to do day-to-day running your business, you're trying to manage your digital marketing and social media. It's a lot of heavy lifting. How can you compete? Well, first, lighten the load. Get in touch with Salem Surround. We take the mysteries of digital marketing off your shoulders and deliver customers so you can run your business. To compete in today's business world, you must utilize every digital marketing tool possible. But who has the time to research, learn, and access all the options? Our team at Salem Surround has the expertise to manage all your digital marketing under one roof. It's easy and there's no heavy lifting. Get started with a free evaluation of your digital presence and some great ideas to increase your online visibility and revenue. There really are no limitations on how and where you can reach customers with Salem Surround. Total market penetration for increased ROI.
Learn more by logging on to surroundmsp.com. Surroundmsp.com, connecting you with new customers.
According to a recent Barna study, schools are seen as a negative influence on faith formation. Church leaders view parents, churches, and Christian communities as positive influences on a child's spiritual life. However, children are spending most of their daytime weekday hours at school, which is perceived by many church leaders as a negative influence. A good Christian school can provide a strong Christian community to help positively influence your child's spiritual formation. At TwinCitiesTuitions.com, we believe in the power of Christian education so much, we have partnered with local Christian schools to offer half off your child's first year of tuition. It's our half off tuition program. To find out if the school you are considering is part of this program, and to take another great step in your child's faith formation, call me, Alyssa Brecken, at 651-289-4406. That's 651-289-4406, or visit our website at TwinCitiesTuitions.com.
Just about 4:34 in the Kingdom Builders Roofing Studio. Thanks for joining us here on the mission. It's Lee Michaels live. Lee's on assignment. We have Jim Moore and Pastor Dwight Anderson filling in. They're from Prison Transformation Radio, and you can catch the show every Saturday at 1 p.m. right here on AM 980 The Mission. A quick look at weather before we get back to the program. Light rain out there. We're seeing some clearing in some areas, but we could see some periods of rain here through the evening hours and the overnight hours. We'll see gradual clearing on Wednesday and maybe some sunshine by the afternoon, but mild temps just shy of 70 for Wednesday. More sun for Thursday, low 70s for the high. Don't forget, Saturday is the big dive-in dinner and discussion event with Dr. Gorka. The event is made possible by Minnesota's Closet and Storage Concepts. You can still get tickets at am980themission.com. Now back to Jim Moore and Pastor Dwight Anderson in the Kingdom Builders Roofing Studio. Take it over, guys.
Thank you very much. Thank you for listening, tuning in. This is Prison Transformation Radio on Lee Michaels Live while he's on assignment. And I'm Pastor Dwight Anderson with Prison Mission Association. My co-host here is Jim Moore with the R3 Collaborative. And we've been talking with Dave Johnson and with Lost Sheep Ministries, and he's going to introduce our next guest. So, Dave, take it.
Yeah. So a friend of mine was saying how she had been working with somebody who was homeless and living in a tent, and how she went over to this place called Frontier Fellowship and talked to Pastor Julie, and the next thing I knew is that this guy was getting housing. And I was like, I got to meet this lady.
Yeah.
And so I called and left a message, and then Pastor Julie called me back. And so it's really been a blessing to get to know her and the people associated with Frontier Fellowship, who are really committed Christians to go out and bring the gospel to the people who are less fortunate out there. And so I've had an occasion to introduce a team of people from Alexandria who came down and went out for 4 days doing outreach with her.
And this is the structured, supportive system they
developed. It was fabulous. Wonderful. And she made everybody feel comfortable. Everybody knew their role, and everybody grew from a result of it. And the one thing I want to say about Pastor Julie is she knows how to love people. That's the one thing through and through. God put it on her heart to actually love people in a way that you don't see very often. Like, I don't know that I've ever seen it to the degree that I've seen it in her.
We're so glad to have you here.
Well, thank you, Dave and Jim and Pastor Dwight, for having us today. So I'm thinking that I'm going to share a little bit about how people can get involved.
A little background, maybe. And again, on June 29th, Pastor Julie is going to do an entire show on specifically breaking it down. But a little background, a little big picture, you know, tease him a little bit as Pastor Dwight would say.
Okay. So Frontier Fellowship is a ministry of Rivertown Christian Ministries International. And my husband Rob and I founded RCMI Rivertown in 2001. And we were called to St. Paul, specifically Payne Avenue, which is really interesting. I knew God could call
you. So you had an address call.
Right, right. I knew that God could call us to a city, but I didn't know he could call you to a specific street.
He's interesting.
So we've been on Payne Avenue. Really, I've been on Payne Avenue for almost 25 years now, even before we founded Rivertown and Frontier. So what I noticed right away was that the culture was kind of coming unraveled, that people did not have the support systems that they had when I was growing up, and that people were in a world of hurt, a lot of mess, even then, even in the 90s.
Yeah.
So we would ask suburban churches to help, and understandably, pastors are busy and churches have their own visions and missions and assignments and callings. Mm-hmm. But we just noticed that there were hundreds of thousands of people sitting in churches that knew that they should be doing outreach, but
they were nudged. With a capital H, was nudging them.
Yeah.
Right. And they don't know how.
Right.
So when we talk to people, they ask us, how can they help? So we're on Payne Avenue in St. Paul, and in Ramsey County, there are thousands, really, of homeless individuals, men, women, and children on any given night. Some are kind of what we call the invisible homeless. They're couch surfing or staying in a car, or even
maybe may be a lot of younger people.
Mm-hmm, yeah. Maybe renting a motel room now and then. Or you have the sheltered homeless who are in the wonderful shelters that are made available through nonprofit organizations and churches.
Yeah.
But there are still many hundreds of individuals sleeping in tents.
Under bridges.
Under bridges, out in the cold weather in the winter, and in the bugs and all of the mess in the summer. So we just found ourselves ministering to the homeless in St. Paul because there was such a need in that area. And like Dave said, we love people, right? Right? If we say we love God and we don't love people, we're kind of kidding ourselves.
That's
right?
True.
Okay. Yeah. So God wants us, God loves people, and he wants us to love the people he loves. So
And it's love made visible.
Loving them. Love made visible. Really loving them. Yeah, not just really thinking nice thoughts about them or you know, having goodwill toward them, but actually caring.
And acting and reaching
actually
out.
Actually caring about people. Yeah.
And
right?
And giving resources. Right. Dave talked about, and he got housing. Right. And I know when Dave was going into the tent communities, hey, instead of just swinging Bibles around and thumping people, hey, do you need some gloves?
Right.
You want a sandwich?
Right. And people ask how they can help, and we certainly do give out gloves and sandwiches. But what we found is by working with people is that they have things that they want to get done. So it's not just us telling them what they should want or what we feel like we're ready to give them, but asking them, really, what would you like your life to be like in, say, 1 year or even 1 month, you know? So some people do want housing. Honestly, some people don't. Some people don't. That's not their top priority. But
so
when
don't
it is,
assume what it is.
Exactly. You cannot assume.
Relate.
Right, because we care about them.
Yep.
Okay?
Yeah.
Actually care about them. So when we find out that housing is one of their needs, we find a couple of things. One is that housing is sometimes available, depending on who it is, what their particular situation is. But there is an affordable housing crisis in Ramsey County right now that's really significantly severe. So housing is not just out there. There's many factors that
make it challenging. Oh, and I know we try to get people into treatment and or just off the street, and there's not shelters available.
Exactly.
So these are critical vital needs.
These are critical needs, and people, we've had families come in with children and had to take them to Fargo or Des Moines to find an overnight shelter for them.
Wow.
We've also had people that just simply had to ride the train all night because there just wasn't anything.
I've heard people, I know Pastor Steger with Grace in the City, they do local mission outreach on the trains.
Yeah, they do. You're right.
Because a lot of people are sleeping, or hanging all night long on the train.
So there's as many different situations as there are people.
If you just tuned in, you're listening to Lee Michaels Live, a Prison Transformation Radio Edition, and we're talking with Pastor Julie Jacobs of Frontier Fellowship. Now, Pastor Julie, if people want to get involved or help, how can they contact you? And then we love telling stories or testimonials of changed lives, so maybe you can tell us how to how people can connect with you and get involved, and then maybe a quick testimonial.
Okay, so we do have a couple of websites. The one that you probably are mentioning this time is letsdooutreach.org.
Let's Do Outreach
is a place where we invite churches and ministries to post their outreaches. So like Dave would have an outreach on there.
A collaborative effort.
Yep, it's anybody who's doing outreach. If we can get you to tell us about it, we'll post it.
That's
one resource. So if someone calls and says we want to do outreach, we can send them to letsdooutreach.org and they can find out what outreaches are going on in their area. What we do at Frontier is literally an orientation. So we invite churches, if they have teams that want to learn how to do outreach, we will have you come in, please just come as you are. We'll go through, you know, exactly what to expect. We worship, then we pray, and then we talk about what we do out there with people. We have several different kinds of outreaches that we do so people know what to expect.
It's going out on the streets then?
Sometimes it's walking the streets. Sometimes we do something. We have a little table that has a sign that says, need prayer,
mark. Prayer table.
We might hand out hot dogs or something like that. It can be many different things. So we work with people and find out what they're comfortable with, and give them an option.
It's kind of like with the people on the street. Meet them where they're at. What are you interested in?
Right, exactly.
What's your passion for?
Right. Mm-hmm. So sometimes they want to bring care kits and hand them out. That's awesome. You know, care kit meaning hygiene supplies and a few items that homeless people would need. So there's all kinds of different outreaches, but we do all of them, and then we give people the opportunity to learn how to do it. And then we go out with them. So we'll take a team of 3 or 4 people. You don't want to go in the homeless camp with 20 people. They're not on the tour. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So they don't appreciate us walking through their living room when, you know, 20 people.
What an interesting picture.
And you have a two-minute testimonial.
Right. So we met a young lady in a tent a couple of years ago. She was in the last few weeks of her pregnancy. Mm. I'm an RN as well, so I'm bivocational, so I'm a nurse as well. So I'm aware of the issues around prenatal care and all of that. So we were able to convince her to come out and get the care that she needed. She had her little girl. Little girl is just about to turn two right now. Mm. And this dear lady now is in the Choices program, which I'll talk more about when we have our program in a couple of days.
And that's going to be on Saturday, June 29th.
1 p.m. Mm-hmm.
1 p.m., Saturday. AM 980, The Mission. Mm-hmm. And it's Prison Transformation Radio. So thank you for laying that out. And folks, there's an easy on-ramp to the freeway.
Again, you've been listening to Prison Transformation Radio on Lee Michaels Live Edition. Well, he's on assignment. And our show is on every Saturday at 1 p.m. So come back with us. We're going to be talking with Pastor Angel Montanez of King of Glory. Let's do outreach in South Minneapolis.
This year, give the most unique gift ever. The thrilling adventure and unforgettable memory of soaring over the St. Croix River Valley in a hot air balloon. For more than 40 years, Stillwater Balloons has provided this incredible experience to thousands of satisfied customers. The sensation of drifting in the breeze between the blue sky and the incredible landscape below is an experience like no other. Soak in the St. Croix River Valley scenery, forests, wildlife, and of course, the spectacular river. Ask anyone who has soared with Stillwater Balloons about their flight, and you're sure to hear words like fantastic, incredible, exhilarating, exciting, peaceful, beautiful. This year, give a Stillwater balloon ride to someone you love. They'll remember it forever.
A great gift for Father's Day or graduation. Visit stillwaterballoons.com or call 651-439-1800. An adventure that will be long remembered. Stillwater Balloons, stillwaterballoons.com.
Is your child allowed to express their love for Jesus Christ in the classroom? Do you want the Christian values you are teaching at home to be instilled at school? At Avail Academy, formerly Calvin Christian School, we proclaim the name of Jesus Christ. We believe that God has made each of us uniquely great, not for our glory, but for His. Alongside the family and the church, Avail Academy fulfills a unique role by instructing and nurturing students from kindergarten through 12th grade. To use the gifts of God for the cause of Christ. We believe in teaching our students to live a life of purpose now, not just after graduation. We are experts at integrating faith and learning. To learn more about Avail Academy or to schedule a tour, visit our website at availacademy.org. That is availacademy.org. Come see how we can partner with you to raise up your children in the way that they should go. Avail Academy, Christian education on purpose.
Did you know that 45% of consumers look at your online reviews, comments, and feedback to decide if they want to do business with you and your company? I'm Nick Anderson, General Manager of Salem Media Group Twin Cities, and I want to introduce you to Salem Surround, the next generation answer to digital marketing for your local business. Salem Surround can help your company get the most out of their online reviews and reputation. Call Alyssa for more information at 651-289-4406.
Lee brings insightful commentary on today's most pressing issues and subjects.
In the 5 o'clock hour, we're going to help you become a better you. How do you share Jesus with individuals with developmental disabilities? We're going to spend some time talking about the dangers of antidepressants. I think it's really important to be able to defend our Christian faith. But we're just going to have a great, frank discussion.
Join the conversation on Lee Michaels Live, weekday afternoons from 4 to 6 on AM 980, The Mission.
Problem on westbound Highway 610. It shut down completely between Maple Grove Parkway and I-94 due to a serious crash. Backup now from Elm Creek Boulevard. Westbound 94 is slow. Riverside to the Lowry Hill Tunnel. Dowling to 53rd, where there's an accident on the right shoulder. And again, westbound 94 past 169 to Brockton Lane is slow. Eastbound 94 slow off of 394 to 35W. Also have a crash on the right side at Highway 280. Another one up the road at Snelling Avenue off to the right shoulder. That delay starts at Hiawatha. And another accident eastbound 94 at 35E is on the right side with a delay beginning around Dale Street. That's a look at traffic. I'm Bill Lindy.
Welcome back to Lee Michaels Live, everybody. This is Jim Moore with Prison Transformation Radio and my co-host, Pastor Dwight Anderson. And we're just trying to fill you in on the wonderful things that are happening in the tragic world. There's broken, lost people. Pastor Julie just talked about in St. Paul that there's thousands of people sleeping everywhere. But there are hundreds of people coming in from suburban churches.
Praise God.
And being trained and prepared by skilled people who've been doing this for decades. And he is the solution, and we are his hands and feet. Right, Pastor Dwight?
Amen.
And so not just in St. Paul. It's probably happening in a lot of places, but we got a passion for the inner Twin Cities, right? And so I, a few years ago, met one of my heroes. And it's Angel Montanez, you know, for European, it ain't bad. But he said, here's how you pronounce it. Angel broke loose. And you got to meet this guy, folks. He's going to be doing a show in a couple weeks talking about what King of Glory, along with City View Church in South Minneapolis, is essentially creating what Frontier Fellowship is doing in St. Paul. And so, Pastor Angel, I just like the word angel.
Yeah.
Welcome to the show, man
you.
Of vision.
Thank you, thank you for having me.
We're going to go in depth on your show in a couple of weeks, but please give us the vision God gave you and give us what he's inspired you to do in your sanctuary in South Minneapolis.
Well, basically, we're addressing what the Lord has burdened our hearts with, because this nation has grown into a diverse melting pot. There are 90 million Americans of Middle Eastern, Hispanic, African, and Asian ancestry.
That's a bunch.
Yeah, and 15% of all people living in the United States, they have been born outside the United States.
Really?
And out of 10 households, 3 households speak more than 2 languages. So basically, dynamic of cross-culturalism and diversity is a reality, even though many out there might deny that. But it's something that is here, and it's going to continue to grow. In Minnesota, there is not an official survey, but there are estimates that regarding the Hispanic population, there are already like 250,000 living in the state.
And that's just South Minneapolis?
No. Across the state. And the Hmong population and the Somali population are in 3 figures too. And there is a projection that by 20 years from now, they're going to grow at a pace of 15%.
Wow.
So basically, the dynamic in the inner city where these people groups are, it poses a challenge to the church as a whole.
Mm-hmm.
How do we go about reaching out?
And your neighborhood, Phillips neighborhood or
Phillips
that area?
Phillips Powder Home. I'm in the boundary line between Phillips and Powder Home.
But that's your hood.
That's
your
hood. The hood.
And I heard that it is the most diverse neighborhood in the country.
Amen.
Over 100 languages spoken.
Mm-hmm.
So that gives you a sense of the diversity.
There are
right?
over 160. There are over 160 people groups, and under those people groups, there. Also on their cultures. For example, in our church, we got indigenous people from Ecuador, from the Amazon, which obviously they might be count as a group, but they're an undergroup. So basically what they speak is not Spanish, but the dialect Quechua. So it's a phenomenon. I can certainly see that in the tribal groups coming from the Horn of Africa. You know, there's cross-culturalism. There's such a diverse part. And the church, the greater church as a whole, needs to rethink the strategy, coming together with biblical foundation, how to go about reaching out, not setting up programs, but reaching out to
personal involvement, engaging with people.
The Bible is our manual. It's basically is what I heard Pastor Julie just relay a while ago. You need to be soaked in the love of God.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
I like the way you say God.
Yeah, yeah. There is no other way. You know, the first commandment really is the most important in the Old Testament and the New Testament. That's the law of Christ. Love God above everything else with all your heart, and then love your neighbor. If you don't love God, then this doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, but if you do, this is compelling.
Then it compels you, because the love of compels you to go about doing our Father's bidding.
Hmm.
So basically, it's not an obligation. It's just a desire to please God, because obviously he has chosen us as the vessels of clay to witness and to share the gospel with the sinners and the people that are lost.
Amen, wow. Amen. If you just tuned in, you're listening to Prison Transformation Radio. We're filling in on Lee Michaels Live while he's on assignment. Please call in if you have any questions. Our number here is 651-289-4499. We don't have much time left here, but can you tell us, Pastor Angel, we're talking with Pastor Angel of the King of Glory Church in South Minneapolis. Tell us a little bit about how people can get involved, or what they can do, and how we can, in this let's do outreach that you're doing there, and maybe you can tell us a little transformation story about a life that's been changed.
Okay, at this point in time, different than Pastor Julie, at this point in time, what we're trying to do is rally churches.
Okay, yeah. Okay, we got them listening. They're listening.
Coming together, because basically, I love to read the book of Judges, because it states more or less the state of the church in my estimation. You know, in terms of there are many things going around, but the 12 tribes were in disarray. So many times the church, even though we have the Bible and we have a great commission ahead of us, sometimes we are in disarray. So what we're doing, especially with City View Church in the inner city, is trying to model a basic kind of unity for not only inner city churches, but suburban churches to come together and obviously pull resources together.
And tell us, what are some of those Apple Valley churches that are engaging?
Oh, yeah, they're
Life
sister Blood? Churches. We belong to the same network of churches.
It's but you want more sisters to join.
Yeah, we are brothers and sisters.
And what can they do? What are we asking them to do when they join this group?
Well, you know,
they're praying. They're
yeah. Well, they're basically, at this point in time, we want to be able to break it down at the level that Pastor Julie is doing. Obviously, that we have a staff or basically platform for people to call and for us to get help, or for them to come in and be part of the ministries of outreach that we got together. To mention the churches, Christ Church and Facing Christ in Eagan, those are the two sister churches, and alongside City View Church.
So
in
other
the inner
pastors,
city.
Join the list, and you can reach out to R3 Collaborative. And Angel, thank you. In on July 6th, right after Happy Birthday America, Angel's going to take a half hour. Pastor Ward McFadden with City View Church is going to join us, and we're going to break it down for you, folks.
All Thank right. you for having me.
Yes, yep. Lee Michaels Live with Pastor Dwight and Jim Moore of Prison Transformation Radio.
And that call-in number is 651-289-4499. Please call in.
Call.
Dr. Robert Jeffress with today's Pathway Minute.
When I read the book of Daniel, I find that Daniel is really a primer on authentic courage. In Daniel chapter 1, you see his courage as a teenager, refusing to eat the king's meat and therefore violate the law of God. In chapter 2, you see his courage in interpreting the dream for Nebuchadnezzar, the dream that spelled the end of Nebuchadnezzar's kingdom. In chapter 3, you see the influence of Daniel giving his three friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the courage to say no to Nebuchadnezzar and not bow down before the golden image. And in chapter 5, you see his courage as an old man in his early 80s, before Belshazzar giving that indictment upon the kingdom that was about to crumble.
Today's Pathway Minute is provided by your station and Pathway to Victory. To hear the Bible teaching of Dr. Robert Jeffress, go to ptv.org.
Are you a member of our rewards program?
Yeah, I had the card here somewhere.
We've all been there, rustling around for a rewards card that you can't find. At AM 980 The Mission, we've simplified the process. All of the perks, none of the hassle. It's the Mission Fan Club, where you'll get early access to tickets for our events, exclusive content, prizes, and more. To sign up, visit am980themission.com.